yourself to arrive on your mat. As you arrive, just notice how you feel. Where is your mind, your body, and your heart, the connection? So I'm going to read a little passage from one of my teachers, Sadhguru, regarding the divine energies. So for a long time, humanity has given too much significance to the masculine because survival has been the dominant factor. Masculine will naturally be the dominant force when survival is a dominant aspect. It is only when societies handle their survival well and reach a certain level of stabilized culture and civilization that the feminine can come to its proper place. Today's societies are coming to that phase, but economics has become the main force in this world. It is only in a certain situation of relaxation that the feminine can flower. And if feminine does not flower, you will have everything in your life and you will have nothing in your life. Consciously nurturing the feminine in a society is very essential, because without that, you will have full-grown trees which will never flower. That is like living half a life. Half a life is not a good life. Start to breathe in and out through the nose, deep inhales and exhales. In ujjayi breath. Relaxing your shoulders. Have your palms facing down for grounding, or facing up for receiving, whatever feels more natural for you today. Press your sit bones against the mat, lengthen your spine, keep those shoulders relaxed. Keep pulsating. Exhale out through the nose. Just focus on those exhales. Five, four, three, two, one. Take a deep inhale through your nose. Hook your thumbs, spread your fingers, reach the arms, apply your root lock. Hold your breath. And release, arms down by your side. Bringing your hands at heart center. Take a moment and set an intention for your practice, allowing yourself to honor both your feminine and masculine energy. Shoulders over your wrist. arch the spine, bring your chin up. Exhale, round your spine, bring your chin to chest. Inhale, arch the spine, chin up. Exhale, round. Two more times, inhale, arch the spine, chin up. Exhale, round. Last one, inhale, arch the spine, chin up. Exhale, round. Start to move a few rounds at your own pace. Sway your hips. Rotate your shoulders. Eyes can be closed. Two more breaths. Hips forward, gently arch the back. Exhale, release, fold over your legs, let it go. Inhale, half lift, flat back. Exhale, hands down, right foot steps back, low runner's lunge. Left foot steps back, high plank. Chaturanga, lower halfway. Upward facing dog. Downward facing dog. Three breaths. Keep those hips nice and lifted. One more inhale. Exhale. On your next inhale, look forward. Exhale, bend your knees. Inhale, step or hop forward. Exhale, release, fold over your legs. Inhale, rise to stand, arms reach up. Exhale, arms down by your side. Feet together, toes touching. Inhale, chair pose. Bend your knees, tuck your tailbone. Exhale, release, fold over your legs. Inhale, half lift, fly back. Exhale, step, hop or jump, take it back. Chaturanga, move to your flow. One more, inhale, and exhale. On your next inhale, look forward. Exhale, bend your knees. Inhale, step or hop forward. Exhale, release, fold over your legs. Inhale, chair pose, bend your knees, tuck your tailbone, weight is in your heels. Stand all the way up, arms down by your side, Tadasana. Inhale, sweep your arms up overhead, push the hips forward, gently arch the back. Exhale, release, fold over your legs. Inhale, half lift, flat back. Exhale, hands down, left foot steps back, low runner's lunge. Drop your left knee, untuck the toes, crescent lunge. Inhale, arms up, sinking forward into the hips. Open up that chest. Exhale, hands down, left knee lifts. A little twist to the right. Inhale, right arm reaches up, keeping your hips facing down towards the mat. Press on your right foot and your left toe mount. One more inhale. Exhale, release right hand down. Right foot steps back, high plank. Take your flow. One more inhale. And exhale. Inhale, step your left foot forward, lower in this lunge. Drop your right knee, untuck the toes, crescent lunge. Inhale, arms up, sink forward into the hips. Exhale, hands down, right knee lifts. And twist to the left. Inhale, left arm reaches up. Press on your left foot, your right toe mounts. Keep your hips facing towards the mat. One more inhale. And exhale, release. Left hand comes down. Right foot steps forward. Fold over your leg. Inhale, chair pose. Bend your knees, tuck your tailbone, meet us in your heels. Stand all the way up. Arms down by your side, Tadasana. Take a moment, close your eyes. You can bring your hands at heart center. Slow down that heart rate. Two more breaths, inhale, exhale, last breath, inhale, and exhale. Inhale, lift your right leg nice and high. Keep lifting that right leg a little bit higher, press the mat away through the palms. Even if you don't do a full split, it's all about that energy. One more inhale, and exhale. Inhale, coming forward to high plank, keeping that right leg lifted. Drop the left knee onto the mat. Hug those elbows in and lowering into sunbird. Keep that right leg lifted. Inhale, push up. Lift your left knee. Three-legged dog, right leg high. Right foot down, downward facing dog. Second side, inhale, left leg nice and high. Point your toes. Press them out away. Keep that energy of lifting that left leg high. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale, come forward to high plank. Keeping that left leg lifted. Drop your right knee. Hug those elbows in, lower that chest. Inhale, push up. Lift that right knee. three-legged dog. Downward facing dog. Beautiful. Inhale. Exhale. One more inhale. And exhale. Inhale, lift your right leg high. Step your right foot forward, warrior one. Left heel comes down. Inhale, arms up. Keep the shoulders relaxed. One more breath. Inhale. And exhale, open it to warrior two. Beautiful. Inhale, reach both arms up overhead. Straighten your right leg. Exhale, we bend. Two more. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, we bend. Last one. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, we bend. Flip the front palm, reach it back, reverse warrior. Cartwheel the hands down, the runner's lunge. Side plank, right leg over the left. Right arm reaches up, keep those hips lifted, flex your feet. If you have an option, you can take it. Right leg away from your left. Right arm over your head. One more breath, inhale. Two more, inhale, exhale, last breath, inhale, and exhale, inhale, lift the left leg high, step your left foot forward, come into warrior one, right heel comes down, arms up, hips facing forward. Warrior two, extend those arms open, left knee is bent. Inhale, reach both arms up overhead, straighten your left leg. Exhale, we bend. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, we bend. Last one, inhale, arms up. Exhale, we bend. Flip the front palm, reach it back, reverse warrior. Cartwheel the hands down, low runner's lunge. Side plank, left leg over the right. Left arm reaches up, flex your feet, make sure your hips are lifted, and you're pressing the mat away through that right palm. Don't sink into your shoulders. Feel free to take a variation. Left leg away from your right. Left arm over your head. One more breath, inhale, and exhale. High plank release. Hold it here. Continue that breath, firing up your belly. As an option, lift the right leg from the mat, flex the right foot. Find that concentration. Maybe extend your left arm forward. Switching sides, release. Lift the left leg, otherwise you're just holding your plank. That's good. And maybe reaching the right arm forward. Slow movements. One more breath, inhale. And release, chaturanga, table flow. We're almost there. After this little bit of a sequence, we're gonna have a nice break.
lifted. Inhale, right leg back. Right knee to your right elbow, hover over the mat. Shoot the right leg back. Knee to nose, round your spine. Shoot the right leg back. Knee over to your left elbow. Ball and star, extend that right leg. Flex your right foot. Left arm goes up, keep those hips lifted. Good. Don't drop your hips, keep them high. One more, inhale. Exhale, release, three-legged dog, right leg up. Step your right foot forward, high lunge. Left heel is off your mat, arms up to the sky. Warrior three, lift that back leg, point your toes, reach the arms forward. As an option, arms down by your side, press the shoulders away from your ears. One more breath, inhale. Exhale, release, hands down, left foot steps back, lower the lunge. Right foot steps back, high plank. You can take a flow or just come to downward facing dog.
Downward facing dog. Moving slowly.
Open into warrior two. Good. Let the front palm reach and back reverse warrior. And let's come into half moon. So as we come forward, if you happen to have any block, you can use it. A few inches in front of your right foot. Lift the left leg and flex your left foot, opening up your hip. Left arm goes up to the sky. Look down for balance. Unless you feel ready to move deeper, you can bring your gaze to the left or to the sky. Maybe bend the left knee, grab your foot or ankle, kicking your leg to open up the hip. Long more breath, inhale. And exhale, soft landing, release, warrior two. Straighten the right leg, pivot your right foot to the left. Wide leg extends, feet parallel, arms extended like a T. Inhale, look back. And exhale, let's fold over the legs. So you can grab your feet from the outside and exhale, pull. You can also just place your palms down in front of you and push the heart forward. Try to keep a flat back. More breaths, inhale, exhale, two more, inhale, exhale, last breath, inhale, and exhale, lifting yourself up, lift the left knee off of the mat, coming into a low runner's lunge, so adjust your right foot, scoot it in, right hand outside of your right foot, and let's move into pyramid. So hop the left foot a little closer. For those at home, if you have a block, you can use a block for your hands. Have those hips squared off. Folding over that right leg for your hamstring. If you're really tight and you're bending the knee, just bend the left instead. See if you can lean back and maybe flex the right foot. Two more breaths, inhale, exhale, last breath, inhale, and exhale, soft bend in your knees, left foot steps back in low runner's lunge, drop the left knee, untuck the toes, and once again, we're going to come into crescent lunge, but this time you can have your hands on your right thigh. We're going to hold this pose for a little bit, so sinking forward into your hips, as an option, you can reach the arms up, opening up your chest. Find the back of the room, otherwise, hands on your thigh. Shoulders relaxed. Inhale. Exhale. One more inhale. And exhale, release your hands down, half split. Extend the right leg, flex the right foot. Point your toes towards your face once again. one more inhale. And exhale, rebend the right knee, sinking forward once again into your hips. Keep your left palm on your mat. Now bend the left knee, see if you can grab your left foot with your right hand. And pull in your leg. Stretching out your quads. And don't worry, we're going to do that other pose. I just realized I messed up the sequence. It's all good. Bring your hands on your mat and then half split. Flex the left foot. It happens to the best of us. One more breath. Inhale. So we bend the left knee, sinking forward into your hips. Right palm stays down. Bend the right knee. See if you can extend your left arm behind you and grab that right foot. Pulling in the leg. Pulling that right heel close to your buttocks. Two more breaths. Inhale. One more inhale. And exhale, release. Lift your right knee up. Low runner's lunge. Three-legged dog. Left leg behind the sky. And making sure that your arms are shoulder width distance apart for lizard on the second side. Stepping your left foot outside of your left hand. Right knee is lifted. Gently rock back and forth. And then when you're ready, find that sweet spot. You can drop your right knee. You can stay lifted or bring your forearms down. If you're open enough, listening to your body. Inhale.
drawn closer to you. And we're focusing on that left hamstring. So if you're super tight and you're bending the knee, just bend the right knee, lean back. See if you can give yourself more space like that. Maybe flex the left foot and release the head. Two more breaths, inhale. If you're holding on to tension, especially in that left leg, see if you can release the left leg down. Two more breaths, inhale. Exhale. One more inhale. And exhale, lifting yourselves up, remaining over both hips. For another quad stretch, let's bend the left knee, grab it by the ankle, pulling in your leg. Try to remain over both hips for a deeper stretch. If you have a variation, feel free to take it, such as mermaid. One more inhale. And exhale, let's release the left leg and swing it around for a seated spinal twist. So the left leg comes over the right. As an option, extend your right leg forward if you need the space. Left arm behind your back to straighten your spine. Inhale, right arm reaches up. Right arm outside of the left leg. Take another inhale. And exhale, twisting to your left. Don't crank your neck. Focus on the twist at the navel. Keep those hips squared off. One more inhale. And exhale, release, counter twist over towards your right. Bow your head if that serves you. And release. Three-legged dog, or downward facing dog, excuse me, however you'd like to get there. So we can move into the second side. We're almost there. Inhale, left leg nice and high. As an option, eyes closed. Coming into your pigeon, left knee to your left wrist, flex the foot, right thigh down on your mat. Get your hips in alignment, spine is straight, inhale, and exhale, slowly descend and release. Try your best to not hold on to that right leg, to the right hip, just let it go. two more breaths. Inhale. Exhale. Last breath, inhale. And exhale, slowly walking yourself up. Remaining over both hips for a quad stretch. Let's bend the right knee, grab it by the ankle, pulling your leg. And once again, try to remain over both hips for a deeper stretch. If it's too intense, you can sit on the left side. One more inhale, and exhale, release, counter twist over towards your left, bow your head if that serves you, and release the legs forward, shake off the legs. So I'm going to give everyone an option. You can just come into, actually just any version you'd like. If you have a headstand, you're going to have about a minute and a half. If you have a tripod headstand, if today an inversion is not for you, just feel free to come into either supported shoulder stand or shoulder stand, right? Whatever feels good for you today. Katie, you like a block?
Cool.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Just take about a minute and a half. Start to descend and come into a child's pose if you were on a headstand or a tripod headstand. For those on your back, just remain on your back. From child's pose, we'll all meet on our backs and hug the knees into the chest. Just start to sway a little bit from right to left. Underneath, and interlace your fingers, try to get your shoulder blades to touch. rise into your comfortable seats with your eyes closed for final meditation. Open your hands together, heart center. Inhale through your nose. Exhale out through the mouth. Inhale for Om. Namaste.